In this video, we'll try to understand how to draw shear force and bending moment diagram in case of the arrangement of the beam as shown in the figure. So it is the case of simply supported beam with end moment. So as you can see over here, first we'll draw the free body diagram for this particular arrangement. Now the given particular beam is simply supported at A and B, and it is having a force of 800 Newton acting as shown in the figure. So we'll use the equivalent load and moment system at point C. So we'll convert this particular 800 Newton force into a load and moment that is acting at point C, which is created because of the force of 800 Newton. So in mechanics, we have already seen this type of the examples. So this 800 Newton force that we'll draw over here in the same direction, so that we have already drawn. Then 800 into 150, so 800 Newton we have converted into kilonewton, so 0.8. 150 mm we have converted into mm, so it is 150 mm we have converted into meter, so it is 0.8 into 0.15. And as you can see, it will create which type of the moment? It will create clockwise moment about point C. So this 800 Newton force as it is, that is converted into 0.8 kilonewton, and because of this particular 800 Newton force, it is creating a moment, clockwise moment of force multiplied by perpendicular distance of 150 mm. So 0.8 into 150 mm, which is converted into meter, that is 0.15 meter. So 0.8 into 0.15, that is 0.12 kilonewton meter. So it is the case of, so at A and B we are having the bearings, so there are support reactions RA and RB as shown in the figure. Then we can say that this is the case of simply supported beam with the end moment. Now as it is supported in the bearing, we are interested in the vertical forces. So applying the first condition of equilibrium to find out the beam reaction, that is summation of Fy is equal to zero, upward forces positive and downward forces negative. So RA and RB, they are acting in the upward direction, that is our assumption, and there is no downward acting force, or there is no other force which is acting in the vertical direction. So minus 0 is equal to 0. So we can say that RA plus RB is equal to 0. The force that is present over here is 0.8 kilonewton, but it is in the horizontal direction, and we are interested in the vertical reactions because of these particular bearings which are present at A and B. Now another condition of equilibrium is summation of moment is equal to zero, clockwise positive and anticlockwise negative. Now we'll take moments about point A. So start with this RB. RB will produce anticlockwise moment about point A. So it is negative. So RB and perpendicular distance between B and A is 0.425. So it is minus RB into 0.425. Then already there is an end moment of 0.12 kilonewton meter, and it is in the clockwise direction. So we can say that it is positive. Now transfer this minus RB into 0.425 on the other side, so it will become positive. So we can say that RB will be equal to 0.12 divided by 0.425. So reaction at B is 0.282 kilonewton. Now substitute that value in equation 1. So equation 1 is RA is equal to, transfer this RB on this side, it will be 0 minus RB. So we can say that RA is minus 0.282 kilonewton. Negative sign indicates that the direction of RA is not upward, it should be in the downward direction. So as you can see, RA we have shown over here in the downward direction, RB is in the upward direction of the same magnitude, and using these values we have to draw shear force diagram. Now the conventions which we have used over here are clockwise, are upward positive and downward negative. So start with point A. At point A there is a downward acting force or load of 0.282 kilonewton. So as it is downward acting, it is negative, so it is 0.282 kilonewton. Just at the left of B, correct, that is B left, there is no other force that is acting between A and B. So whatever the force is there at A, the same will be there at point B. Exactly at point B, there will be an upward acting reaction RB. So it is minus 0.282 plus 0.282, that is 0 kilonewton. Now shear force at point C, as there is no load that is acting between B and C, it is also 0. So using these values, we have to draw the shear force diagram. So as you can see, at point A it is minus 0.282 kN, will remain same up to B left. Exactly at B it is 0 kN and will remain same up to point C. Now we have to draw the bending moment diagram for the given particular arrangement. So conventions which we have used are clockwise positive and anti-clockwise negative. So bending moment at the end of simply supported beam is always zero. Bending moment at point B, consider all the forces which are acting on the left hand side of point B. So there is only one force, so RA, which is acting in the downward direction, and it will produce anti-clockwise moment. Distance between A and B is 0.425 meter. So as it is anti-clockwise, it is negative, so it is RA multiplied by 0.425. so value of RA is 0.282 into 0.425, it will be nearly 0.12 kN meter, so minus 0.12 kN meter. Bending moment just at the left of C without considering this clockwise moment of 0.12 kN. So all the forces we have to consider on the left hand side of C. So we can say that on the left hand side of C again there is a RA, so but again it is producing anti-clockwise moment about point C, but the perpendicular distance is 0.425 plus 0.25, so that is 0.675, and as it is anti-clockwise it is negative, so it is minus RA into 0.675. this upward acting arrow of RB will produce clockwise moment about C, so it is positive, and the perpendicular distance between B and C is 0.25, so that also is nearly 0.12, so it is minus 0.12 kN meter. Now exactly at point C we have to add this clockwise moment to this particular value, so minus 0.12, as it is this particular moment is clockwise, it is positive, so minus 0.12 up to C left plus 0.12 exactly at point C, so value is 0. So using these values we have to draw the bending moment diagram. So we can say that at point A it is 0, at point B it is minus 12, just at the left of C it is minus 12, and exactly at point C it is 0 kN meter. So in this way we can draw shear force and bending moment diagram for the typical arrangement of the beam with end moment as shown in the figure. Thank you very much for watching.